This series of instructional videos will help you to understand some of the basics of the collection process that we use. In the lab, we implement a number of methods in order to collect certain information about the brain and its processes. Today, we will be learning a little bit about prepping for EEG. Each electrode is labeled to a universal standard. In this way, the labels can be used and people across the world can understand which placement the study is referring to. The first letters for each electrode corresponds roughly to the different areas of the brain, that is, the frontal, parietal, occipital, temporal lobes, as well as the central sulcus. Rows between these major landmarks are identified with two letters. The last letter or number signifies the position relative to the midline. Z signifies the midline of the brain. The numbers get bigger the farther they get from the midline. And the numbers are even on the right side and odd on the left. A1 and A2 are the reference electrodes and in our lab are placed on the mastoids. The HEOL and HEOR are the left and right temporal electrodes, and the VEOU and the VEOL are the upper and lower eye electrodes. The ground electrode is always prepped first because EEG measures a voltage, which is a difference. So, as the CZ electrode is held in place, hold the rest of the cap over the head of the subject. This way, we have a better chance of keeping the electrode in the right spot. Pull the chin strap around and fasten it tightly next. Eyeball the cap to make sure the electrodes are in straight lines. Then, re-measure the head to make sure your middle electrode didn't move. Over time, these caps can lose some elasticity and we often use tape or mesh to keep the caps tight and the electrodes against the scalp. Hook up the face electrodes to the cap. The left mastoid connects to A1 and the right mastoid to A2. If the cap is too loose and you can't go down a size, a piece of mesh can be applied on top of the cap in order to flatten the electrodes to the head. Again, this is specific to our procedure, not necessarily a needed step. From here, the cap must be plugged into the head box and the software program Neuroscan should be open on the computer screen. The head box amplifies the signal and converts the signal from analog to digital. The next step is to prepare the electrodes. Impedance is essentially a measure of resistance. So, lower impedance means higher quality signal. It is important that the impedances be relatively the same. Impedances are represented visually by a change in color for each electrode on the screen. You can see that each box represents an electrode on the cap. Right now, all the electrodes are pink because the impedances are high. Ideally, we would like the impedances to be dark blue, which represents the lowest impedance. The procedure to prepare the cap electrodes is similar to other electrode prep, but we use different tools. A blunt needle filled with conductive gel is our tool. The needle end fits the holes of the electrodes. The needle is inserted into the electrode and rested against the scalp. The needle is then moved gently over the scalp in small circles to move the hair out of the way and to slightly abrade the skin. It is important that the end of the needle is actually moving across the scalp because if the tip is sitting in the same spot, it will not properly prepare the skin and more importantly, it will likely hurt the participant. After swirling around in the ground electrode for a bit, add a tiny bit of conducting gel as you slowly remove the needle from the electrode. This leaves a small stream of gel connecting the scalp to the electrode. You should then see the screen electrode impedance change color. After you finish all the electrodes, the Neuroscan program should look something like this. Notice that one of the mastoid electrodes remains pink. The electrode will stay that color because it is the reference, not because there's an error with the electrode. Now you're ready for EEG collection. Hopefully this video gave you a better understanding of how to prep an EEG cap for collection. Please stay tuned for more videos in this series.